Okay, good morning everyone. So today we're gonna group two want to present it about the CBL2 Transformer Practices Project. My name is Hafiz Resandi.
My name is Gabriel Felicia Kalista.
My name is Anisha Prastiarini.
This is the table of our content.
So this is the assessment. The subject assessment is Mr. Hendro was addressed at the Bakti Jaya Village. The height is 160 cm and the weight is 47 kilograms. The employment is freelance, skill level 2, dependent is 2 children, education senior high school. Time travel to the JSBO is 45 minutes by ojek online, and for the environment is his house and workplace. Environment is even terrain.
And for the subject assessment, he got leg amputation in 1987 due to train accident and was amputated at the Rumah Sakit Cipto Mangunkusumo. His right arm got fractured and pain on his arm bone until got amputee in 1996 because the arm cannot heal well. A single parent has two children. He is a smoker and coffee drinker.
Hendro has unilateral transfemoral amputation and unilateral transradial amputation right side due to accident. He already has 4 devices at 2009 from wood material at 2011 and 2013. And now he uses his prosthesis for a day and takes it off only if he is taking a bath and sleeping.
So the operation problem expectation for the problem is because he lost the weight, and then also the process is too low and solution belt is broken. So the expectation is the socket is snugly fit to the stump and the height is with same with the sun side.
For the objective assessment is general health has a heart attack issue due to his pulmonary problem and the trunk asymmetrical shoulder level, no scoliosis, and for the upper limb, he has an unilateral right side transradial amputation, and for the lower limb, unilateral right side transfemoral amputation, and for the lower limb stump, he has a medium length and a fragile soft tissue consistency and hip flexion contracture.
This is the ROM and MMT.
This is a special test for the sharp emblem is good. The posterior drawer test of the knee is stable. Forus valgus test of the knee is stable. It's for the sun side. And the forward bending test is negative. So no harm. The Thomas test is positive. And then the has a flexion contractor about 10 degree. For perception is good. Reduction angle about 10 degree. Maximum hip extension about 10 degree extension. Femoral angle 20 degree. And for the ramus angle is 31 degree.
From previous device from the corona, he has a teratoma bending, excessive intra rotation of foot, abducted gait, and circumduction. And for the sagittal, he has a anteroteral bending and terminal stance, terminal swing impact from the terminal swing, and an uneven step length, uneven timing, and uneven arm swing in a stance space.
The prosthetic goals, first is replace missing body part, second is restore the function of the foot and the knee, provides enough fit socket and comfortable to use of the prosthesis, improve the stability, provide lightweight prosthesis, support patient's activity, improve gait pattern, and the prosthesis measurement match with the patient's condition, height, and socket volume.
The real prescription is customized unilateral right side thermoforming ischial containment socket transformal prosthesis with suction valve suspension with polycentric free motion knee joint with endoskeletal shank and such foot.
Real prescription is customized unilateral right side transformal setting RevoFit socket transformal prosthesis with silicon.
Sorry,
vacuum and lanyard suspension with polycentric free motion knee joint with endoskeletal shank and Therion foot.
The ideal prescription for the upper limb is unilateral right side transradial prosthesis with monster socket and passive hand.
The bench alignment for the transverse is foot external rotation around 5 until 7 degrees. For the sagittal is the goal angle is flexion up to 15 degrees. And for the coronal is the adduction up to 7 degrees. So this is the gait deviation from the sagittal. It's from the fitting. The first is anterior trunk bending. So it's at the anter at the early stent phase or especially at the initial contact to the loading response. And the next one is uneven arm swing. The sound side is more far away swing than the amputated side due to the patient has transradial amputation. For the uneven step length, the sound side is more step than the amputated side. And for the uneven timing also, the longer at the sound side than the amputated side. And for the fistoning action, due to the patient has because the socket is not snugly fit to the patient's thumb. So while swing pace, the prosthesis is has a downward motion to make a piston action at the initial contact, and then also has excessive lumbar lordosis. It because the patient has the hip flexion contracture 10 degrees, and we give the 15 degrees for the initial socket itself. And then because of the hip flexion contracture itself, the patient needs to do anterior trunk bending to move the COG is anterior of the prosthesis, anterior of the hip, on the knee, also the ankle to make stable. But the patient didn't want to do the anterior trunk bending entire phase, so the patient do the excessive lumbar lordosis. Maybe the rest want to add.
Okay, in here we create the initial flexion in 15 degree because there is a flexion at 10 degree hip flexion contractor. So function of at 5 degree flexion, hip flexion is the function to pre-stress the hip hip extensor. The function is to control the prosthesis during early stents and late stents. So for the patient already pre-stress the hip extensor, the patient can be control the prosthesis easily during initial contact to loading response, which is in that phase the hip extensor is work to create the prosthesis in stable by the pulling the hip in extension position to create the knee in extension position.
Now plan, so the patient has lateral trunk bending, so it's because the trunk is bent to the trunk is bent to the amputee side, so this gait deviation is appears during initial contact to the mid stance. So first the possible causes from the prosthesis itself is because insufficient femoral support on the lateral socket wall, because the socket on the lateral wall has gap it wide open, and also from the amputee's causes is because the patient has weak hip abductor muscle, and then the second gait deviation is abducted gait, so the patients walk with wide walking base because the patients feels too long due to the socket is loose, and then this gait deviation is appears throughout the stent phase.
For the treatment plan is cardiologist to treat the heart condition, prosthetic for provide prosthetic, and do follow up for the prosthetic itself. For the physiotherapy is to help to do exercise targeting joint mobility, muscle strength training, cardiovascular fitness, balance, and etc. For the dietitian is helping patient to understand adjustment to eating habits for heart healthy diet, and for the patient and family education to provide emotional support to the patient itself.
And for the pathology is traumatic by the train accident injury, is a physical injury of the sudden onset, and severity which require immediate medical attention, and for the causes by a variety of external force which affect the body, and some of the causes is a vehicle accident.
For the fracture, for the lower limb, the patient has open fracture, so the type of the pattern of the fracture is comminute, and based on the Gustilo classifications, the patient has type 3C, means there is a large wound with major arterial injury.
And the next is for the upper limb, it's called fracture. The classification is C3 from the OTA classification, which is multifragmentary.
It is a heart disease. So the heart disease can be blood vessel disease, such as coronary artery disease, and problem with the heart rhythm and heart defect and heart valve disease and disease of the heart muscle and heart infection.
Of the heart disease is plaque buildup in the arteries or atherosclerosis that prevent blood from getting to the heart muscle. And the symptoms of the heart disease itself is short of breath, easy tired, and edema.
For the diagnosis is electrodiagram, blood test, and etc. For the treatment is with drugs. And this is our reference. Thank you. The member can talk about more about the prescription because we have still 1 minute.
Ideal prescription, we choose the Revofit because the Revofit is good for the patient have the fluctuating volume, and then the socket can be adjust the fluctuating volume if there is a stem is bigger and then smaller can be adjusted by the BOA dial, and then it is good for the patient have the it can be operated by one hand and then easy to donning and doing rapidly.
And also for the suspension itself is for vacuum lanyard, bony locking, and proximal closure. It's increased good perception, feel lighter, using vacuum and simple to use, and secure for comfortable. So for the socket material is divided by two, the outer and the inner. For the outer socket itself is from the thermosetting carbon fiber. For the inner, thermoplastic flexible material. For the carbon fiber itself is due to the strong and durable, lightweight, seamless, so make little chance for cracking. For the inner itself is for permit volume chance of stump, more control over the processes, easy learning, and also the doffing. So.
And for the knee joint, we use the polycentric knee joint because it will give the excellent knee stability from the location of the instantaneous center of the rotations, and also it will be enhanced to clearance throughout a swing phase. And for the shank, we use the endoskeletal because it will be easy to adjust compared with the exoskeletal. And for the foot, we use the Therion K2 foot because it will be lightweight the Therion itself is like the energy storing foot, so it will be lightweight and durable. And also stable because there has a split toe, so it can adapt the uneven terrain and also smooth rollover. And for the other feature, we choose the soft cosmetic cover silicone material because it will protect the prosthesis, provide an anatomical shape to the limb, and also prosthesis will give the similar appearance to the opposing limb.
Okay, that's all from me, from us, and we have one video to make more familiar to the Revofit socket itself. So the Revofit itself has a panel, and it at the anterior and can be lateral. And for the adjustment, can with the BOA dial, so it can be changed, but just adjust it. And then for this socket itself, it can be changed easily for adjusting the socket volume of the stem itself. Well, maybe the rest of the member can explain more about this socket.
And then also this socket will be good for the patient. It will be easy for the patient during donning and doffing, because we just can turn the dial to make it doffing or donning, so it will be related with our case that the patient has transradial amputations, so it will be easily for the patients to donning and doffing, because we consider the patients using one hand to donning and doffing the socket.
And the feature of the Revofit itself is he has a boa dial, BOA dial. BOA dial itself, one of BOA, it's the function to make a snug fit of the socket by controlling the three panel by tighten or rotate the BOA, and the other of the BOA is to create the snug fit of the proximal closure by tighten or rotate, and then to easily the patient to donning and doffing. When the donning, the BOA will be loosened by pull. It can create the proximal part is loose, but if already done, the stem insert to the socket, tighten the BOA to create the proximal part is tighten and snug fit.
The patients.
Yeah.
Ideal prescription you use the this type of the food is energy storing. Is it right or not?
Yeah.
Including the energy storing or other type?
Energy storing food.
What are you using real prescription for the food?
For the real prescription, the socket using the ICS and the skeletal and the knee joint with it polycentric knee joint free motion, and for the foot using the SAGE.
Okay, can you explain more what the benefit of the energy storing food?
Okay, I want to try answer, and the rest can be added. So for the energy storing food, the benefit first is it can be create smooth gait pattern because there is a spring action during early stance. The spring will be compressed to save the energy, and then during late stance, the spring will be loosened and then give the energy for the propulsion. And then the benefit second is there is a split of the energy storing foot. The function of the split itself is can be adapt uneven terrain during walking, and then create stable. And for the foot itself as using mechanism the material itself using the carbon fiber, and then create lightweight and for the durable for the patient.
Any other question from the audience?
Can I ask?
Yes, Aci.
Yes, Aci.
Still in the prescription, you guys prescribe about the Revofit socket, and I want to ask how the Revofit socket it will it will adjust for the patient with the fluctuating stump.
Okay, so the Revo-fit socket, it has a double adjustment, is micro and macro or macro. So first adjustment, it can the volume adjustment for the socket is can be from the panel opening of the patient of the socket, and the second adjustment it can be from the socket itself. So as like the video, it has a dial that we can adjust by rotate the dial to make it snugly fit the pump.
And for the dial itself is connect with the lanyard, so the dial will be rotated to create tighten and can be pulled with create the loose of the panel or the proximal part.
Can I ask?
Yeah.
Okay, so regarding your ideal prescription, you said that RevoFit is for TF amputee, right? So it can be used for trans-tibial or only transfemoral amputee can use this kind of socket?
Okay, so for the RevoFit itself, it can be used for the TT, can be used also for AD. So the system of RevoFit itself, it's suitable for the fluctuating volume for any stump, not only on the transfemoral but also the transradial, Putri, because the first thing at the RevoFit itself, it's because of the system of adjustable for fluctuating volume, which is from the panel itself, from the adjustment itself, from the socket has two socket material, which is the outer and also the inner. So it can use for the other type of the socket, not only transfemoral.
Okay, thank you, Gigi, for the answer.
Yeah, I want to ask.
Rafika.
Yeah, Rafika.
The ideal prescription is the RevoFit design. Is the in the TT, there is also another RevoFit for the TT? If there is, what are the different design of the RevoFit itself for the TT? If is it same design or have a different feature?
Okay, I want to try answer. So for the RevoFit design is many type of RevoFit design. It can be transfemoral, transtibial, ankle disarticulation also. And for the transtibial itself has a feature from the it's same feature with the transfemoral, but the difference is the panel itself. For the panel from the transtibial, the panel has three panels. One panel on the medial flare, and then lateral, on the lateral side, and also the at the posterior or in the gastroc muscle, and the mechanism is same with the BOA dial, it's combination with the lanyard can be adjust with the tighten the BOA or rotate the BOA. And also can be and some feature is on the patella tendon. The patella tendon can be adjust with synergy with the volume of the trypanel itself with BOA. BOA dial.
Thank you.
Okay, I want to ask. So, in the ideal prescription, you guys mentioned about the Therian food, right? I want to ask, what is the advantage of the Therian food in term of the green gate, I mean?
Okay. I want to answer first, and the rest can add my answer. For the one that advantage for the when walking for this patient, it's first from the foam base that has been mentioned from the office, which is it as a shock absorption. So on the initial contact to the response, on the normal gate, the foam base the heel need the leg, I mean, need to shock absorption by the plantar flexion of the ankle. And if compared with the oral prescription, which is as such, so there is no access. And if we want to do a shock absorption by plantar flexion, the processes will do compensate it to become the foot is flattened to the ground by the therion because it has a foam base, so it as a shock absorption, so it as the other it be done, the shock absorption it be done by the foam base itself, so it create more stable and not like the processes want to go going to the compensate for make the foot is flat to the ground itself. It's from the initial contact to the other response. Okay. And the other, maybe you want to add?
Okay, maybe I want to add. So the differences between the such, the advantage itself for the therion is because the therion itself is has the split toe to adapt uneven terrain. So it will be it might be increase the stability of the patients during walking and also standing. It's if we compare with the such that didn't has the split toe, so it will be less effectively to adapt uneven terrain if we compare with the therion foot.
Thank you for the audience to and also the question. That's all from our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you.